Let's face it, we don't always have access to perfect green screen setups, but that shouldn't stop us from being able to use green screen footage in our projects. In this tutorial, I'm going to show you tools you already have available to shoot some green screen footage and then key it out with pretty decent results. The first thing we need to do is import our green screen footage. To do that, go to File, Import. Drag the footage to the New Comp button. As you can see here, I have some green screen footage that I took with my cell phone, handheld, in front of a green shirt that I just held up in the air. Did not use any special lighting, have lots of wrinkles. This is pretty much the worst case scenario when you're trying to do a green screen. But I'm going to show you how you can key it out pretty simply with After Effects. In your Effects and Presets window, type in Key. Then, what we need to select is a single instance of the Keylight plugin. Drag it onto the clip. Get the eyedropper by screen color, then select a color that's near the object you want to key out. For this technique, we are going to use two Keylight effects. For this first effect, we just want to get a really rough instance of the figure or the object, so we can be very aggressive with our effects. The first thing to do is to click down under Screen Mat, and then also show the screen mat result. What we want to do is clip the black levels pretty aggressively till we don't have anything in the background, and then clip the white levels pretty aggressively so there's nothing remaining here. We can clip the black more to get rid of this spot right here, so I'll do that. Because this is an imperfect shot, no amount of black clipping will get rid of this section, but we can easily get rid of that by using a garbage mat. So I'm going to do that with the pen tool. Draw out a mask with the pen tool. And notice everything disappeared. That's fine. We can twirl out the layer, and under Masks, Mask 1, we can say Subtract. Now switch from Screen Mat to Intermediate Result. Not a bad key, but what we want to do is improve it even better with less aggressive clip black and clip white. To do that, we're going to expand the mat with a choker. In Effects and Presets, type in Choke. Drag Simple Choker onto the clip. And then type negative 100. This brings a matte edge out from the original alpha channel of the original key light. Down here, we're missing just a little bit. We can just duplicate it by pressing Command D, and notice that I get more of that hair down at the bottom there. This may or may not be necessary for you. In the timeline, right-click and pre-compose. By default, when you are selecting a single layer, it will say leave all attributes in the main comp. We don't want that. We want to move all attributes into the new pre-comp. We want to relabel this garbage screen. Now all of those effects are inside this pre-composition garbage screen. Now go back to Effects and Presets and type in Key. We want to use the animation preset Key Light, Key Cleaner, and Advanced Spill Suppressor. Drag it onto the footage. This time, once again, we'll click on the eyedropper somewhere near the footage. And now what we need to do is, instead of Screen Mat, because if we click Screen Mat, it'll show both mats. What we want to do is show Combined Mat. That way it will add up the different mats all together. One thing that sometimes is helpful, you see how we can see some green here? You can double click and move this around just a little bit to see if it makes any difference to get a better key. Now twirl out Screen Mat, and we can clip the black levels. Then we can clip the white levels. What we want to do is check a few other places to see how this is working. If you notice up here, I still have some black to clip, so I'll do that. Now switch to Intermediate Result. This is a pretty good key. What we need to do now is click Advanced Spill Suppressor, and there we go. Press N to change the work area, and do a RAM preview by pressing spacebar. As you can see, we have a very good key, even though we didn't spend any time to set up a green screen. Let's add a new layer to show off the effect of our green screen. I'm going to move this layer below our footage. Then let's set some keyframes. Press P, then hold Shift, then press S. Drop a keyframe by pressing the stopwatch, then move forward. Move the text to where we want it to end. Hold Shift to drag back to the other keyframe. You can also press the J and K keys to toggle back and forth to keyframes. Here, let's make the scale 0. Now we have animation that can exist behind our figure, all keyed out. Who wants to be stuck with a cheap green screen when we can go to the ocean? So let's go back to our project window, go to File, Import, and drag the ocean scene down below. There, not a bad result. Of course, you would get much better results if you spent a little bit of time to straighten the fabric, maybe get a desk lamp or two to light the green screen fabric behind you. But I wanted to show you that you can get excellent results without much effort. Hopefully, you can have fun making green screen footage anytime you want. Just grab your cell phone, something green or something blue, or anything of a solid color that's different than red, and shoot away. If you like this content, please click subscribe for more tutorials.